Stocks pointed to a flat open on Wednesday as global shares paired gains after renewed concerns that the U.S. was moving closer to launching military action in Syria. Good morning. I'm Jessica Minton for IB Times TV, reporting from the New York Stock Exchange. On Tuesday, President Barack Obama clinched the backing of key Congress members, such as House Speaker John Boehner, for its push for U.S. strikes on Syria, which is suspected of launching a chemical weapons attack last month. Leaders of the U.S. Senate Foreign Relations Committee said they had drafted authorization for the limited use of military force in Syria and have set a time limit of 60 days for any action with a 30-day possible extension. The measure will now be voted by the full Senate on September 9th. On the economic calendar, a number of economic releases are due on Wednesday, including July's trade report and vehicle sales figures. Also, the Fed will publish its latest edition of the Beige Book, its region-by-region assessment of the U.S. economy. In earnings news, Dollar General reported second quarter profit 3 cents above estimates, while revenue also came in above consensus. Heavy equipment maker Navistar reported a fiscal third quarter loss wider than the per-share loss that analysts had predicted. Revenue also fell short amid weaker truck industry conditions. Finally, Ciena, the producer of telecom equipment, earned 23 cents per share for its third quarter, excluding certain items, 7 cents above estimates. The company's revenue was also above consensus. Investors are also looking ahead to the G20 summit taking place in Russia on Thursday, where Syria is likely to be in focus again. Check back with me in midday trading for my preview of what to expect from this week's G20 summit.